Hi, I'm Brian with Kissmetrics, and I'm here to help you get the most out of your Google Analytics account. Today, I'm going to show you how to track every single instance of a link that you send out. Imagine this, you've spent months making this killer product. You've thrown up a landing page to it, and now you're going to send out several tweets to drive traffic to your landing page. And you send out a series of 15 tweets over the course of a week, and you drive 5,000 people to that landing page. Now you want to step back and see which tweet drove the most traffic. If you put the same link in every tweet, that's impossible to do. However, with the method I'm going to show you today, you can know exactly which tweet drove the most traffic, which link people clicked on the most. Then you can use that on Facebook posts, on your landing pages, on your website, different places on your website to track which specific link sending traffic to the same URL drove the most traffic. Today, I'm going to teach you about UTM parameters. First, I'm going to tell you what they are. Second, I'm going to show you how to set them up. And third, I'm going to show you how to read your Google Analytics report to gain valuable information to use on your site. So, let's get going. So, what is a UTM parameter? UTM parameters are simply tags that are added to the end of a URL. So if you've ever been to a website before, looked in the address bar, and noticed the URL was this long, it's probably because it was using UTM parameter tags. What this allows you to do is when a user clicks on that link, all of the tags are sent back to Google Analytics for tracking. I use this on my personal site for promoting my video training course. So I promote it in several spots. I promote it on the sidebar, in the footer, in my bio page, and at the bottom of every blog post. And I do this by creating a unique URL for each instance of the link. And that URL looks something like this. When I go into Google Analytics, I can see a report very similar to this that shows me all of the analytics of that exact link. You can customize your UTM parameters to tell you almost anything you want to know about the details of how people are getting to the most important parts of your website. This can give you an even better idea of what really works in terms of your online marketing. So in a nutshell, a UTM parameter are simply tags that you add to the end of a URL that allow you to track each specific instance of a link. The simplest way to create UTM parameters for your links is by using the Google Analytics Link Builder. Right below the video is a link to that tool that you can use right away. Now let's walk through the process of building a link inside the Link Builder. The link we're going to make is for a blog post that I'm publishing in a week. And at the end of that blog post will be a link to my free video training course. And what I want to do is be able to know how many people clicked on that link inside of that blog post and how much traffic that generated for me. So let's head over to the Link Builder and get started. You'll immediately notice six form fields on this page. There's only four that are required, so we're going to focus on those to start. First, in step one, is the website URL. This is simply the URL of the page you want the user to land on once they click your link. So we're going to fill out the URL of my landing page here. Next is the campaign source. This just needs to generally identify where the traffic is coming from. In this instance, it's coming from a blog post, so we'll just enter blog post. Third is campaign medium. This is simply a parameter that identifies the medium which the link was shared in. In our instance, I want to identify the exact blog post that the traffic came from, so I'll use the blog post title here. Last is campaign name, and this is the highest most level of identifying your links. So I'm going to group a lot of stuff inside of this campaign. I'm going to title it Video Fruit Landing Page. And this is simply every link I'll make in the future that sends people to my landing page for my free video course will be inside of this campaign. And this just groups them all together in one nice spot. Now, press the submit button and your new URL will be generated below. Just copy and paste it into the blog post and you're all set. So that's it, you're all done. Don't get too tripped up on campaigns and sources and mediums. How you use and organize your UTM parameters boils down to how you want to see your information displayed inside of your Google Analytics dashboard. The way I prefer to see it might not be the most useful for you. My preference is to have the campaign as the highest level of organization, your source as the middle level, and medium as the most detailed level of organization. So in our particular example of linking inside of a blog post to my landing page, if I wanted to create a new blog post in a day, I wouldn't have to create a new campaign and a new source. I would just add another medium to the list there. If I wanted to link another section of the website, if I want to experiment with different sidebar widgets that link to my landing page, I wouldn't have to create a new campaign. I would just create a new source called sidebar widget, and under it, I would create all my different variations as mediums. There's no right or wrong way to do this. Just use it in a way that works best for you. To view your campaigns in Google Analytics, you'll go to the website profile and click on Acquisitions, Campaigns, and then go to Sources and Site Usage. Here you'll see an overview of your various campaigns as tagged using the UTM campaign parameter. You can then click on the campaign name to see the additional details as tagged using the source and medium parameter. And that is UTM Parameters 101. There are all types of ways you can use this in your website to find out how your users are navigating your site and how they're finding particular parts of your website. What I want you to do is in the comment section below, share with the community how you use UTM parameters. Do you have a specific implementation that's very cool, that's giving you valuable data that maybe we haven't thought of before? If so, share it. Well, that's it for this week. Until next time, happy analytics.